Progress at the site of a train derailment in southwest Jefferson County. The chemical cars are all stabilized and restrictions are lifted. Let's give you a live picture now of the scene from the WLKY news chopper. The P&L Railway train derailed 1 week ago along Dixie Highway and Catherine Station Road. And now the attention shifts to getting things back to normal in the community. Let's bring in Lexi Sheen, who's live at the command center now with the latest. Lexi, where does the cleanup kind of go from here?
Well, Eric, at this point, the good news is Dixie Highway has reopened, but only to the people who live in the area and also to service personnel. As for when the roadway will reopen to the general public, crews say the biggest issue right now is getting equipment moved out over there, but still keeping workers in the area safe. They say the reopening completely could come by 6 o'clock tonight.
We're going to put some additional barriers in place. We're waiting on some additional signage, and we're going to restrict some of the speeds of traffic down to 20 miles an hour or so, because we want people to be very careful when they go through there.
Today morning, the fire in the butadiene car is out, and all of the rail cars have been uprighted. But even though they are safe and secure, there are still 6 chemical cars that need to be offloaded. At this point, crews say there is no plan in place for that process, which will have to be done by the product's manufacturers. So far today, though, railroad employees have been working to rebuild the portion of the track that was damaged in Monday's derailment, and we're told they can have that reconstruction done in just about 12 hours. P&L CEO says this has been a major disruption to train traffic for the railroad company. Today's focus remains on getting commerce back open.
We hope to have the railroad open mid-afternoon today, and should have everything cleaned up as far as our equipment. And then once they transload, we can get back to clean up the environment and get things back to normal.
Now, emergency crews say a 72-hour notice is required for companies who want to offload those hazardous materials. That means that process certainly will not be beginning today. As far as the cause of the derailment, that is still under investigation. P&L says their outreach centers for those people who have been inconvenienced by this entire accident will remain open as long as they're needed. Live at the command center, I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.